Now that we have our slab cut to size, the first thing we want to do is go back to the templates that we created with our sketches. The idea behind sketching these out to size is that we can transfer the image onto the clay. This will be much easier done while the slab is still flat, as opposed to trying to draw your imagery when the mug is in the round. Even if you plan on adding sculptural pieces to your mug, doing this will give you guidelines for where you want to place those sculptural items. For example, by the time I get to that paw print, I do plan on making it an additive piece, but by having the outline, I know where I need to put everything down so that it looks like I want it to. So all I'm doing now is using something sort of pointed, but still a little blunt, so that I'm not tearing the paper, and I'm just going over my designs so that the pressure of my tool will leave a vague outline on my slab. These guidelines might get a little bit lost as you start to put your mug together, but it should last just enough so that you can refine it when it comes time to finalizing the designs on your mug. And this is the end result that I will refine later on. So now we get into actually forming our mug. You want this to be soft, but not too soft. If you start to lift your slab and you notice that it is stretching and losing its shape, it is a little too soft and you should probably let it sit for a minute or so. Maybe hit it with the blow dryer so that it can get a tiny bit firmer. If it does not retain its rectangular shape, you will not get an even mug. Do not do this with your slab just yet, but notice as I start to form this into a cylindrical shape, those edges will be very hard to meet up as is. So what you need to do first is bevel the short ends of your slab. Beveling simply means to create a slope or an angle. If you recall from the making a slab video, I asked you to cut this out so that your ends are 90 degrees, but we need to make it so that the short ends are actually 45 degrees. Right now, I'm just going to lightly mark my ends so that you see what I mean. Eventually, I will go along that mark and cut all the way down. Now, this part is very important, and I try to show this as best as I can. If you were to imagine this edge as a very, very long rectangle, you need to make it so that the two 45-degree bevels are parallel. So that means that if this really long rectangle were a shape, it would be an equilateral, not a trapezoid. So this is the way that I find the easiest to actually bevel your ends. If you lay your slab flat and simply angle your cutting tool at that 45 degrees, you can slowly start to cut that edge off, and what you cut off will end up being triangular in shape. Now, since the other end needs to be angled in the same direction, I will end up doing an undercut, which I don't particularly prefer. You are welcome to do it, but what I actually like to do instead is flip my slab over and then cut my other end from the back, and it will still end up being a parallel cut. Now you are ready to form your mug. It actually doesn't matter which way this is facing, but as we have learned, it is very important to score and slip. So I am scoring the beveled ends that I've just created. I apply slip to just one end, and from here I can start to stand my mug up and slowly form it into a cylindrical shape. You will begin to see the purpose for beveling our ends because it allows our mug to overlap without creating a fat or thick part on the mug. So you should line up those beveled ends, and what I'm doing here is I'm pressing from both the inside and the outside to create a strong bond. This is perhaps the most important part of the process because if you don't get a strong connection where your mug connects, it will possibly pop open and you have just rendered yourself a useless mug. Once you have pressed your ends together, you can blend that seam over, making sure that you're actually moving the clay and not simply just petting it. If you like the look of the raw seam, you can actually leave it showing, but you must be confident that you have really connected your ends well. And this might be the trickiest part in this video. You need to also try to blend the interior seam. You can use your finger, you can use any tools you might have, but this part is important if you want this to eventually be a functional mug. If you can get your inside seam to look a little like this, I'd say you've done a pretty good job. The last thing I'm doing at this point is taking my wet sponge and running it along the top lip of my mug. I'm doing this to make the lip of the mug a little bit more soft and more welcoming in the event that I eventually drink out of this. I'm just gently reforming it now back into its circular shape, and you are halfway there.